Alright guys, I have another one out, and I finally found the secret.
Alright guys, I'm gonna kind of start where I left off. I worked on extending the injector wires, and I'm going to make this its own this harness, and I'm going to leave it separate, and I'm going to put connectors on the ends inside of the car. These are the, what do they call them, bullet splice connectors. I'm going to put those in it, so if I ever need to pull it out or do something different with the swap, I can disconnect them without having to cut the harness up more. And so in return, I'm going to wrap this, make its own harness, and I'm actually going to run it opposite. So usually, this would have been on this side, and this is the driver's side where the injector box went. So I'm actually going to turn it around, and I swap the wires to do so, and I'm plugging them in this way. So we'll come underneath the manifold, hook the OBD1 connectors in there now, and I'll run these just along the main harness into the firewall. So this is all going to be connected. I left this on there for the people that are still, you know, keeping OBDO, because I am going OBD1. I already have a plug that goes on this, just to show you on that. So I'm going to snip this. I need to extend that too, probably just a little bit to make it reach where I need it to. So let me get the wrapping everything up. Two harnesses worth of this stuff. All kinds of pieces. I'm trying to work on using some of this and get it back on the here.
We'll be right back.
Okay, so here's the injector harness with the Obi-Wan adapters already in. And I'm just gonna tape up this end all the way down to here with these. I'm gonna have this sticking up so I can have the clip and the pinned already attached connector to erase the resistor. If not, there is where your resistor would go for the ODO. And then this will go to the number 15. Let me look at this again. So A15 injector resistor, black and yellow. So that's where this wire will go, connect into A15. And then injector 1, 2, 3, and 4 will go in 1, 3, 5, and 7 spot. And I got extra wire just to make sure. I numbered all the ones that I needed to make sure I had the right injectors when I put it in the car. I'll show you how to move the pins and to de-pin inside the car, moving to the spots. Some of you may have an extra pin that's already in one of these slots, in number B12, and you can just use that. So I'll show you all that when I'm in the car. But let me just wrap this up, see if I have a little bit more of the protective cover stuff I put on the harness, and kind of make this one piece. This is going to go along the firewall and attach to it to get it out of the way, and it's going to come off on the passenger side instead of how it ran on the driver's side in stock. And so let me tape it up, cover it up, and few scrap pieces left. I'm gonna just cover up some of this. Hopefully, just protect it a little bit more. Put a piece down here to protect this and where all the connections are for the wires, just to make sure. Just run a couple pieces down there. And don't forget, you took a whole bunch of these things off, their boots to go over them, and they were taped on, and it's where the clamps go on to hold it on. So I'm not going to put those on until I get into the car. I can slide these back over, find the right points where it was mounted on the car, and then I'll tape it back on to the harness so I can put the metal clamps around them and use them. So don't forget about those. Make sure you still use them. Protect your harness. You still need to keep it whole. Held down from rubbing and falling apart on you, so make sure you kept those and you use those again. So let me finish wrapping this up. Don't forget these when you get out there, and I'll show you the finished product. Up, taped up, and sealed. Now it's protected, and we're there. We're at the point where we're going to get out to the car now, connect all the wires up where they go, get the manifold in, make sure all the wires and plugs reach, make sure we don't have to extend any of them, make sure we get all these pinned into the ECU set up. So yeah, it's not too bad. Took two good harnesses, the dual port and the multi port, to make me one good multi port swapped harness. And had plenty of cover stuff, so I didn't have to buy any of that. The swap, because I got the multi port harness for like $30 plus the wire and the tape, I'm in at $42 or so. So I have this complete swap ready to go, wires protected, taped up into the car, a one-off custom setup that I put together for my car for 42 or 43 bucks. Can't beat that, since the full dual port to multi-port swap harness online is running about $200 right now. So I'm excited with it. It seemed to turn out well. The real question is, now we got to make it work and make sure it works. So hopefully on the next episode, that's what we will go over.
All right, guys, just want to show you the aftermath of this project. This is a bag of just old tape and crap I cut off. The amount of grease, I washed my hands and they're still nasty. And dirt that come off these things is unreal. All over. So again, public service announcement. Do not ruin your Aunt Bessie's, grandma's, mom's, sister's, girlfriend's, whoever's tablecloth or sheets, because it gets gross. So here's the aftermath of all that getting done. Got a part of a harness. I got a whole bunch of pieces to attach to the harness and left over from that harness. I got another bag for all of that harness. Get that all on there. And then I had a bag of tools. So this is a fun day project. I had to finish up this evening. So it took me, I guess, 2 days, but really only a few hours to take the multi-port harness that's in that bag, use the dual port, add stuff to it, and to make that. So yeah, it was good. I'm excited. And there's the finished harness. Let's get it in the vehicle. What you think?
Alright guys, so I'm gonna take out the ECU and unplug them so I can pull the harness through the other side. Make room up there with the grommet so I get the other plugs in I need to. Work on getting my OBD1 in here, connecting it all together, and then work on getting the multi-point fuel injection harness in under the hood. So we'll go from there. Let me take it off. There's usually a plate over this. As you can see, it's stripped. I started getting out most of the sound deadening material, and I ran a line for my battery relocate kit. So it's pretty easy to get to now because I did all that. They're just 10 millimeter bolts. And I only got a couple of them holding it in. So I knew I'd be doing this in the future. Let's see here. That easy. Alright guys, here's that Monotech harness that he got together for me, and it plugs in to the factory spots that we just pulled out, and then we can hook up our P28 ECU for the vtec, and hopefully it'll sit here in the same spot. We can make it all look awesome. Cheetah power. So, we got some color cool matched. Let's plug right in. Not easy. Really easy, actually. And then there's spots here, so they're all a different size, so they can only go in one spot. Well, there that is. And then here's the plug for my vtec harness. There it is. That's where I'm gonna have to bring in my other harness at. see if I get a better picture of this here. So that's the stuff I was moving out of the way. Now I can see inside. Yep, awesome. So there it is. Snapped in, plugged in. Now go up top and work on that.
All right, guys, I got the harness kind of in place and checking its fitment. Worked on getting the manifold over here to make sure the plugs will match up. And everything's looking good so far. So we got the standard two plugs over here that went in. Here's my add-on right here. I'm going to tuck it along it. It fits nicely down inside. My injector harness is way too long, so you definitely don't need as much as I did, because I made it run from this side down and in. If you're running it back around along the firewall and in, then you'll need that much space. So I got it all hooked up. I got the little rubber pieces on, a couple mounts holding it into place. I plugged the wires down here, connected the alternator, I got it plugged up here. Got it tucked up behind the brakes. This plug here is going to be definitely long enough to get over here. This plug is going to have to come up onto the side back here. It will have plenty of room. It will have plenty of room going from there. There's plugs over here. I think I'll have to extend one of these to make it work for the throttle body. So I'll figure out what this stuff up here is doing. But everything's looking good. The alternator's in a good spot. Got all the wires down here plugged in. Got the ground in. Got the starter in. Got the fuse piece in. So it seems to be fitting all right, and everything should meet up where it needs to be. So that is a great sign. And that makes me happy. So here's the one plug that I tucked down here. Got this wire coming up and over the booster. So we can just probably retape it. Get it to sit down there nicely. So it's just out of the way. Not hurting anybody. Not getting destroyed by the weather, so it's looking good. Everything looks to be good and to fit nicely. So I'll have to show you how to do the pin on the inside of the ECU. Alright guys, I'm going to show you how to work on this part. How to de-pin and get stuff ready, where it's located on the ECU. Pinning stuff and how to swap it. And go from there. So there's all the good stuff. So right here we have those injectors. Here's 1, 3, 5, and 7. So injector 1, 2, 3, and 4 will go right here. This is where so that's the pin. See? So this is one on the outside. The number 15 spot, that is the resistor. So kind of pulled these out, separated them, because I'll be cutting these up here and cutting them up there and splicing them into the wires that come back out of there for the injectors. I don't have the injector harness quite in yet, but I might see if I can pull the wires through and kind of sit it. I just don't want to break any of the clips or the harness. So then here on the paper it says move wire from 1C to B10, move wire from 2C to B12. So you see that white one there is in my B12, and there's 10 is open. They're supposed to be open. So online people say you can just get it. I already de-pinned it, trying to figure out what it is. I'm actually going to take it out and cut it and use it as one over here
for one of these blue wires to connect to. And then I might even pull one of them out of here for, no, from my AC, because it's not even hooked up, so I don't need my AC pressure switch set up, whatever the pin is for that one. So I'll take one out to use on this side as well, so I can wire them in. Because I can't find the one harness I clipped off of a car from a junkyard that had all these pins. I have all this from the junkyard, all the connectors. And I don't know where it is, so I'll just do that to make it work. So that's an important thing. If you're at a junkyard, people may hate you. Come through, take a snips, trim you off the harness, keep the plugs and the pins so you can wire in stuff later. We can always repair them or do whatever you need to in the future. Add vtec and different stuff like that through the wiring. So all these clips, they have these little safety devices that slip in here. And so you just push them on the sides and they're spring actioned, and then you can lift them up. There's a little lip right there. So yeah, gotta take those out, get ready to pin. I already depinned the C clip, which is the slightly smaller one. And I took out number one and two, which is the orange and the white, like it says on the paper. Oh, focus. See, orange and white. And then I'll have to run pins from C1 and C2 are now empty. And that's what I'm going to run for these blue wires. So, yep, let's get underway, get it going, and kind of show you what I'm doing. Alright, guys, so I put in the orange into the 10, B10, and the white into the B12. There. And they just snap in. There's only one way they can go in and lock in. So this one here, B3, back here, that is my AC clutch, relay. Excuse me. I don't have AC, so I'm going to take this yellow one out and move it over here with this one. As well, I'll be using this extra one that was in B12, which normally is clear. This one was there, so I'm going to use it on to C1 and 2, so that we can connect up the wires. So I'll show you how to depin this bad boy. Take this clip out here, lift that up, how to pull out that pin. Alright guys, I have another one out, and I finally found the secret. I went out, bought this repair needle kit. I couldn't get enough pressure with the little screwdriver. And so, I have a needle, and I'll show you what I did. I stick it into the center hole, and then I literally set it down and press to push it, because I wasn't getting enough force with the paper clip and some other things, kind of get them in there far enough to let release it and push it up. So let me see if I get close to the pin so you can understand what I'm talking about. So right back here, see that focus is there. Oh my goodness, come on. It's not focusing very well, sorry. Okay, that little edge right here where my thumb is. You gotta push that down to get it to come out. So I'll show you what I did, shoving the needle down the long side of that and using the force literally pushing down on the clip with the needles. So this one right here was the one I was originally trying to get. This other one was an AC one. So all I did was get it, stick it into the center hole where it was, where the clips can come undone. Okay. And then I kind of pulled on it so it's pointing in the direction I want. And then I push down. And then I pull it out. That easy. Okay. So now that I got that figured out, should make life a little easier getting this thing together. And I might just cut that one and keep it as a spare. But that is how you do it. So, yes. So now I got the two in C1 and C2 that are going to connect up to the blues. So these will go onto these. And all my ejectors will go in here. Hopefully you know how to wire them. Like I said, if you're looking from the back. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 injector. So make sure you label them. And then for the sake of the EF group, here is the one for the resistor. So you cut it, you connect it to this, connect your ejector to that. And that should be good enough to help you do what you need to do to get it sorted out.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning into this episode. Just sitting in the Spork sedan in my nice Recaro racing seat that I got for the cheap and I fixed. I'm excited to do these videos. Hopefully this is helpful for you. Hopefully knowing the pinout, some of the papers can help you. I'll try to put some of the links in there from where I got the stuff. And make sure you guys like and subscribe. You know, give me the thumbs up. And comment below if this is helpful. If there's anything else you guys would like to see. And let me know how I'm doing. I appreciate it. You can find us on Instagram. You can find us on Facebook. Everywhere. You know, email me at sporksports@gmail.com if you have any other questions that I can't answer super quick through YouTube messages or comments or whatever. So I don't mind helping you out. Hopefully we can get the right information for you and get you in the right place. So I appreciate you guys tuning in and staying, you know, stay tuned for more of this going on. I got the manifold together. I'll show you all those sensors and stuff I got. The manifold looks like it'll match up well with the wiring harness I put together. And hopefully I can get the car started soon. So that is the goal. To get this car started so I can start driving again. I miss not having something to cruise in that's manual. All I got is that good old family race fan, which everyone needs one of those in their life. All right, guys. Till next time.